Elion Adonai.
Elion, Elion, Elion Adonai.
Oh, I may be small.
I may be small.
I may be small.
But I carry the Holy Ghost.
Oh, I may be little.
I may be little.
Oh,
but I carry.
Elion Adonai,
Elion, Elion, Elion Adonai.
Oh, Elion Adonai,
Elion, Elion Adonai.
I may be small,
I may be small,
I may be small. I may be little,
I may be little,
oh,
but I carry the Holy Ghost.
Oh, Elion Adonai,
Elion,
oh, Elion,
Elion, Elion Adonai.
Hey, Elion Adonai,
Elion, Elion, Elion Adonai.
Elion, Elion, Elion Adonai. Oh, Elion Adonai.
Elion,
oh, Elion Adonai. Oh, Elion Adonai.
Elion,
oh, I may be small.
I may be small.
I may be small,
but I carry the Holy
Ghost. I may be little,
I may be little,
I may be little,
but I carry the Holy Ghost.
Oh, Elion Adonai,
Elion,
oh, Elion,
Elion Adonai.
Oh, I may be small,
I may be small.
I may be small,
but I carry the Holy Ghost.
Eternally, you are glorious. Eternally, you are beautiful. Eternally, eternally, you are God. Eternally, eternally, you are glorious. Oh, eternally, you are beautiful. Eternally, eternally, you are God. Eternally, eternally, you are glorious. Eternally, you are beautiful. Eternally, eternally, you are God. Oh, I may be small,
I may be small,
I may be small,
but I carry the Holy Ghost.
Hey, we may be little,
I may be little,
oh,
but I carry the Holy Ghost.
Hey, I may be small,
I may be small.
I may be small,
but I carry the Holy Ghost.
Yes, we may be little,
I may be little, but I carry the Holy Ghost.
Oh, Elion Adonai,
Elion,
oh, Elion,
Elion,
oh, Elion Adonai, oh, Elion Adonai,
Elion Adonai,
I may be small,
I may be small,
I may be small,
but I carry the Holy Ghost.
Oh, we may be little,
I may be little,
oh,
but I carry the Holy Ghost.
You are good, you are kind. I have never seen your type. I'm devoted to your praise and forever to your name. You are good,
you are kind.
I have never seen your time. I'm devoted to your praise and forever to your name. You are good,
you are kind.
I have never seen your type. I'm devoted to your praise and forever to your name. You are love,
you are light,
hey. You make everything alright. I'm devoted to your praise and forever to your name. You are love,
you are light,
hey. You make everything alright. I'm devoted to your praise and forever to your name. You are good,
you are good,
you are kind,
you are kind.
I have never seen your type. I'm devoted to your praise and forever to your name. You are good,
you are good,
you are kind,
you are kind.
I have never seen your type. I'm devoted to your praise
and forever to your name.
You are love,
you are light,
you are light,
you are light.
You make everything alright. I'm devoted to your praise and forever to your name.
Now, there are times when situations get so unbearable. There are times when you want to call God faithful, you feel as though you are doing injustice to yourself. I don't know whether you have been in a situation where God seems to be unjust to you. It looks as though God is angry with you alone in the entire span of the world. In that kind of a situation, you need a song that can give you consolation. You may sing the song and cry and shed tears. It's a kind of sacrifice that prayer may never be able to give. There are times you wake up to pray. You ask yourself, why do I have to pray? All the prayer before, what have they done? At that time, you lift up your voice and cry in the modicum of your sorrow and your pain. You still lift up a sacrifice unto the Lord. At that time, you are best. God will accept that kind of sacrifice than the man that he has given you 10 million. Everybody can come and give testimony how good things were, how good you got that thing yesterday, how this thing happened to you. But when it did not happen, do you have a song? Do you have a psalms? Do you have a word to tell the Lord? What will give you energy and strength sometimes is the utterances you bear, even in the midst of your pain and trials. It will look as though it will not count. There is a day of reckoning. There is a day of reckoning. We may look stupid, we may look foolish spending time praying now. I assure you, if as long as the earth remains, seed time and harvest will never cease. Whether you like it or not, seasons will always come. You don't pray for rainy season. No, you don't pray for it, it will come. You don't pray for winter, you don't pray for summer, it will come. You can never, never stop season from showing. The Bible says the cloud is full of rain, it will empty itself. Wise men, prepare, invest, so that when season come, they take advantage of it. What we are doing right now is preparation. It's preparation. I assure you, if you can judge God faith, you know, the secret is to ensure that there is something you can tell the Lord in the midst of trials. Many of you, the devil just tried to shut you down. You must know how to awake again. Job may have nothing to say, He can only remember, even though he slay me, yet will I praise him. It's enough a tongue he can speak. I'm assuring you, there are times when the devil wants to relegate you, want to bring you to a state of decadence. You can lift up your voice and say, oh God, even though you slay me, yet will I praise you. It's not as if the thing was easy. Because at the time that he began to complain, while he began to complain, it looks as though he was not the one that said that. Everybody go through trials. Everybody go through situations. But the utterances you speak with matters. The Bible says, if your strength fail you in the days of battle, it's because your strength is small. Now is the time for us to gain strength. I told you, these guys had accident, they almost died. Look at them now. Devil is a liar. He will always remain a liar. But he will force you to believe that he's a good devil. He will force you to believe that he's saying the truth. Please, I know it's not easy, but I assure you, if you remain consistent in this investment, it will amaze you. It will amaze you what your life will become. Many of the things that kill people, silent people, will never happen to you. I'm telling you the truth. Many people today are surviving on the last strand of the mercy of the prayer they have prayed yesterday. They are sinners, so they are backsliders, so, but still God is keeping them. Why? When God looks upon the investment of what they have done, he still preserves them for a while, hoping that they may return. Prayer is an investment. It's an investment that will always speak. This is the reason why Boko Haram are being encountered by God. It's the reason why Jesus is appearing to Muslims in their box. Not because they are righteous, because people have invested prayer. Cornelius does not know what he was doing. He was just praying and offering alms, and an angel appeared. Because what he was doing was not what normal men should do. You may not understand what you are doing, but I assure you, it's an investment. When many years ago, women would give, ladies will marry and cannot give birth because doctors are diagnosing rubbish. You, your own is sanctified. When many rubbish begin to happen, you discover that your own life has changed. Why? Because of just the prayer you are praying. The prayer you are praying today may never have any relevance for you now. When the result begins to come, it will amaze you. Maybe peradventure you are about to travel and die. Everybody may die, you will survive. Why? The prayer you are praying. So please, take this thing serious. We may never pray like this again till the next month. But you can never, never, never remain the same if you engage in this protocol. That's why you see me pray the way I pray. There is no man of God in this place. I told you, anytime you come to retreat, forget about your title. Forget about who you are. Wise men are the ones that wait on the Lord. Only wise people, they give a counsel. The young men will fail. No matter how strong you are, you will become weary. There is no man that can walk without getting tired, without fainting. There is no man that will fly without what? Without getting tired. It's not possible. You must faint, you must get tired. But it's a day that wait on the Lord. So it's a counsel for you to wait. Wise people, as they advance in life, they are waiting. If you don't, you will expire. It's not a matter of how. God have no respect of person. Do you know how many billion people are in this world? You can be replaced in no time. Every Superman you clap for today, one day he will die a hero. But when you die a hero, we don't need dead heroes. We need living heroes. So another person will take over. Wise men wait. Wise men what? Wait. You have to know how to wait. This is part of the process. Can you come in, please? He's going to take us for that. Come in now. What's the name again? I forgot it. Delami. Delami is part of people that refuse to die. I want us to start with people that refuse to die. You know, I fly into Uwele. The first thing I saw was, he said, the city where the colonial masters refused to die. Do you understand that kind of a slogan? The city where the colonial masters refused to die. It means that although these men died, but their voice is still speaking. These men are dead, but the lifestyle they live is still regulating their society. That somebody has died 30 years ago, you are still mentioning the person today. You don't understand. Oyedepo say leaders in Africa are only recognized after they are dead. It's an evil spirit. But I want you not to be recognized when you are dead. Let us not come and gather and say, Kai, esteem you to be a good boy. No, let's recognize you now. Everybody today died, they will say he's a good person. Because you are pitying the dead body. As if the person will stand up again. So please, these are part of the people that refuse to die. But the reason why they survive is because they are praying. After 5 days of prayer upon the mountain, we now did Lafia must pray, Lafia prayer concert. We now did dinner. Is it the dinner that we did that we are wrong? Because the dinner doesn't look like what we did and pray. Or is it because we dance there? You know, I dance too. Yeah, Delami. I mean, Iman, Mary, and Delami, they say they're going to go back house now. And as they were in their home magic. You know, the home magic, they have 3 legs. Is it 3 or 2 legs?
2 legs.
Okay, let's say power bike. They're in their power bike. As they were in their power bike, as they were moving, the bike stopped on the road, on the main road. No car coming left or right. Stop and fell and somersaulted with them. You know that one is spiritual. Because that's not how the bike that your father drives does. It took them and hit them very well. There was no car coming left or right, and there was nothing that would make that happen except a spirit was involved. These were the calamities that before people like Job. Job was sitting in his house offering sacrifice. He was still offering sacrifice. A beast came and stopped the sacrifice from going to heaven. Afterward, a star fell upon his children. All of them died. Another star fell upon the cattle. All of them died. Another star fell upon. And in one day, Job became a broke man, although he was the richest man in the East. When spirit beckon upon you, you need the backing of God. So when the gods beckon up, because what that thing intended was to kill you people that day, it was dead. You see, when you see an accident happen, what the devil intend, if you see it, you will tell the Jesus, you will tell the Lord, thank you. Because what the devil intended was not for you to remain here and even come and be giving us revelation. No. The devil wanted to be 6 feet below. In fact, by now you should have been lunch and dinner for termite. But look at them here. They refuse to what? Can you refuse to die? I always refuse to die. I travel all the time. I see accident. I see death. Sometimes I visions. You know, I teach you about visions and dreams. I don't believe my dreams and vision. I don't believe them. I change them. Why? I'm a man that pray. Because sometimes I'm traveling, I'm seeing that I'm going to die. I will not laugh. People will look at me. So you don't understand. I was in the flat one day, I shouted. I was in the road one day, I shouted. Why? Because I see things that I don't agree with them. I refuse to die. Everything is possible to them that believe. I choose to believe the report of the Lord. I will never believe anything that is not of the Lord. If even in the Lord give me what is not right, I will change it. If the Lord tell me, Philip Cephas will die tomorrow, I will say, why? Why? Tell me the reason. Then let your blood speak. Men pleaded upon the blood of Jesus and they were delivered. If the blood of Jesus is important, let me plead upon the blood of goat or cow or bull. What's the need of it? Never keep quiet. In priesthood, when you keep quiet, you choose the other report. If you don't say anything that I say, remain binding. That's why when we come to the place of prayer, it's dangerous for you to keep your mouth shut. Because you don't know what we are saying. Maybe you are releasing some utterances, so although bullet will be hitting you. And that's why you return and you are weak. Other people went with strength. You came and received weakness. They exchange their weakness and they give you. When we are exchanging, you are receiving weakness. And after 3 years, you are backslidden. You don't even know where you are in the radar again. So you started together. But 5 failed, 2 failed, 3, 4, 5, 2, 4, 9, 1, only one person surviving. What a disgrace. Please, you must insist not to what? Don't die spiritually. Don't die academically. Don't die in anything. If anybody will succeed, say you must be the one. Believe that. I call it the victory. I taught you now. Victorious what? Never receive any mindset of a failure. Never believe it. Yes, they say you fail. Refuse. I'm telling you, whether your father look at you and curse you, see, there is a realm beyond curse. It's a realm of victorious mentality. The curse that kind of person, it will never. There are people in Lagos that work with a curse, and yet they are laboring every day to survive. He's still surviving. You don't see that. See, there's a curse. Your laziness make the curse effective. Please, refuse what? Now, I told you, when I saw Ima that day, I almost wept. I'm telling you. Ima, the type bandit like this. Ima works like this. we have to boggle him and bug him and bug him. At 2 o'clock, I'll see test. I'm about to die. Do you text you too? He text you too. You see test, I'm dying. This I'm dying. And ask her, what will I do now? Look at them. They refused to die. Mary was crying. Went to the doctor. They were stitching her mouth. They were just stitching everything. Mary that was dancing. Oh, Mary. You saw her? Oh, you didn't see her that day? Ah. Mary took the show that day on the dinner. Oh, Mary. You know, that day I saw someone. I said, you were really, really not as spiritual as you think you were. What? Wow. No. Prophet, didn't see that?
I see, sir.
Oh, my God. You know, we will boot suit, so we still look like men of God. Don't ask a lady out on the day of dinner because all of them are qualified. I saw our ladies I could not recognize. So, oh Mary. But while I went to the hospital to see Mary, when we drove to the hospital, there was no beauty to behold in Mary. They took away the weebor, took away everything, the clothes, everything was scatter. I look at Mary again. And the eyes was closed because everything is swollen. She can't even recognize me again. The devil came. Jesus said the devil came and find nothing of his own in me. Dead men don't die twice because what? They are long time dead. If you are still alive, devil will come to kill you. Die to yourself. You can't take anything. So look at them now. Look at this guy. Is he even standing? How even standing? It's the grace of God. It's the grace of God. So refuse to die. So when we say pray, pray very seriously. I remember one December that Paul too was moving with bike, Nabi. You will not know that time. Most of you are not here that time. He was moving with bike. I saw the bike stop like this and carry him tumble like this. And he carry his mouth and hit like this. That's why you see this thing that you see in here is not guy. It's actually it's a dividend of the labor of grace. I'm telling you. They put water and put blood and put everything for Paul. I'm telling you, it's the devil. The intention was to do that, then the cow will come and crush him. But God liveth in heaven. And because he has prayed before, heaven will beckon upon to preserve him. And no matter the devil do, he what? Refuse to. Please, refuse to die. A man will never die until he give up in his spirit. If your spirit give up, you will die. If your spirit refuse to give up, even if your body is not alive, they can't bury it because when they test, you know, when those doctor, where are you? Tell me, when you put the telescope, you see the person still breathing, and you cannot bury a dead man, except because you're not a Muslim. You cannot bury, a man that is alive. You get it? Refuse to die at all costs. I'm telling you, refuse to die. Anytime you hear that we are dead, we are not dead. The day you hear I'm dead, I'm not dead. Wait again, I will come back. It's too early to die. It's too early. It's too early to die. Why should I die? Give me just 2 reasons. You can't find one. Why should I live? I can tell you 1 million reasons to live. You are number one. Each and every one of you is enough reason for me to live. Before I start going to other nations. There are not too many people like you in this world now. I'm very serious. There are not too many people like you, Adams. Check an average believer outside there. The level of carnality they display. You are very important to God. God cannot kill you anyhow. That's why where people pass and they die, you will pass and you survive. It's not about you. It's a cry of destiny. I'm telling you. There are times we escape death. It's not because we are too powerful. Destiny is beckoning. No, this guy is not yet done. So even if you choose to die, you will not die. I'm telling you. They will carry you like Jonah and throw you. Shark will swallow you and ensure that it's a good vehicle to deliver you to the location. I'm telling you. You will never die. If you believe it, it will be like that. If you don't believe it, it will remain like that. I get what I'm saying now. We went to Bloomfield to go and do outreach. Me and Paul. You know, we have special plans for the leaders. There is one village we want to go again. And all of the leaders must go. Me and Paul went after we crossed. You know, the first time when we went, we have to enter canoe. The canoe was just, you know, it was just dumbling down. I know I can swim, but my challenge is the animals that are inside this water. So the problem is not my swimming ability. The problem is the animal. The animals too can swim because that is their habitat. You get it? You cannot run faster than a fish inside the river. Is that not true? You can't run faster than a fish in the river now. The problem is not to fall inside the water and swim. The problem is will you survive because shark is there. Hippopotamo is there. What again? Crocodile is there. Some of these carnivorous, also all these fishes that eat people to the inside. I know those village rivers also are witches and wizards that fish. And they have inside. All those rivers that eat at least 2 people per year. And maybe that year they have not eaten. You coincide with their own time of sacrifice. You don't understand. You need the help of God. So if you don't pray, at that kind of situation, you are gone. And now to make the thing worse, the person that used to paddle the canoe, the person now was not available. They now carry one small boy. That small boy that is like our last born, that should be the one to paddle all of us, carrying our bike and everything, we're very plenty. Hey! I now knew that the devil has planned it and orchestrated. Because devil used to plan things in time. You are the one that don't plan. Devil has planned you before primary school, secondary school, and everything till now. You are still working according to the same plan. You don't know. And he has not given up because they have plan A to Z. When you stop at plan B, he has Z. So that part adventure, if you go like this, you will go like this. And I knew there's a problem. When we climb the thing, do you know the funny part? Normally, if you enter canoe, there is that thing that there is, they will put something so that if water is entering inside, you can be packing the water. And they forgot what to pack water at the river bank. So immediately when we enter inside, water began to enter inside. I know when water began to enter inside, that law of Archimedes and upward, it doesn't work again. All those Archimedes principles, it doesn't work again. Law of flotation is a waste of time. Now they are broken the law, you receive the consequences. We start thinking about our phones and the bike and everything, and also thought about the animals that are inside the water. Because it's vast one. What? And the water, the thing was just entering inside. Then we started doing like this. Paul, look at me, I look at him. He laugh, I laugh. I say, today, not today. The guy almost wanted to start crying, the guy that is driving us. Said, now we have to test oil. You know, at that time, you don't speak English again now. We engage a ram that walk. We start praying. So let's die praying. At least as I'm appearing in heaven, I'm appearing in heaven with tongues. But don't die crying. No. Sometimes when I go to hospital, I see those people that are about to die. I tell, let's pray. So that you are dying praying, you enter straight. Angels will not even stop you. When they were killing Stephen, when they were stoning Stephen to die, he was praying. See, he was muttering words. I need to hear what he was saying. Sometimes when I read that place, I enter into those realms. See, the Bible says, and Jesus, he looked into heaven, he saw Jesus standing. Because what he was saying, Jesus was just waiting, come, then he gave him the goose. That was what happened to Jesus Christ on the cross. He was on the cross, they do for him to die. No, he could not die. Atmosphere shake. Everything happened. Earthquake happened. When he gave up the goose, heaven's open. That is a better way to die. Not you not enter. You not start opening book and check whether your name is still there. People like John Knox, people like John Hall. When these men when they are burning them to this, you know, you read SS and S, and you were singing that song and you are sleeping in the church. Those were what people wrote when they were dying. I read the story of those Bohemian guys that were persecuted. And John Knox, they would tie this guy. They would tie them to a stick, they will tie them to a stick and they will set fire and burn them the way you used to roast what? Goat. Now, how many of you are there who did barbecue here? And the host go there. And you'll be hearing the smell. Have light ever burned you before? You see the way your body smell. That's how they burn them. And you know, the problem with this thing is this. Daniel, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, they throw them inside fire. Fire did not burn them. They may throw you, the fire will burn you. And the same God. You know that's enough. Look for a song you will sing at that time. That's your only deliverance. I'm telling you. That's how immediately most of them will stay and begin to sing songs as they are burning them. They will sing song until they die. And as they are dying, that spirit leave them and enter into other people. That's how people like Paul were included. Because when Stephen was being changed, he was there. And many other of the apostles you can't even know now. The same thing happened to them, John Hus. That's how people like Martin Luther and all these people came. If not, Protestant will never be a possibility. As men were dying, they sang songs. Please, you must understand that the investment you are doing today is because of the millions of people of the world. Do you know how many people you alone can reach? You alone. This one of us reach millions of people. We think it's easy. During the birthday of fans, that if you know the kind of people that will make them download those songs, one person can reach to millions. Look at what people like them, Sinat, and what's the name of these other ladies? Mercy Chinwe. Sing one song, it's millions of people. Millions. So if God, they pray and grow more stature, it's not about herself. This has nothing to do with you. I'm telling you the truth. Please, when we say pray, so that you don't die cheap there. Imagine those people died. Please. We refuse to what? No matter how that thing did that day, do you know with the water entering inside that boat or canoe now, we were able to cross to the other side. We went to the village, we wrecked down havoc, lay hands, cast out demons on all the small children. I knew it was them that saw from the vistas. You know, those children are very spiritual. They saw and they decided those things to happen. They manipulated the waters. When they discovered that after we're done casting out, when we are going back, they said, we'll meet at the going back. And they waited for us. While we went, as we took the bike, here to here we tumble, here to here we tumble, here to here we tumble. I know there's a problem. And then some guys came out to help us. They carry me, carry Paul, with a different one. We went, but they cannot bring us to Lafia. So the time came, they not give it to Paul. I know sometimes the apostolic spirit comes with stubbornness. We know that we are under attack. These guys are following us. We are speeding. I know speed on the wrong direction is disastrous. Speed is only an advantage on the right direction. We were speeding. When we leave this airport road, I don't know what happened. Suddenly, I saw a wind blow from the sky. Foo. And one light came. Bah, bah, bah. You know, there are some thunders that were not from heaven. Some thunders are sent by Babalao. Now, I came into Lafia. I was here yesterday, the day before yesterday. There was a thunder that struck. I almost felt as though the person I prayed for is the idol in the family that wanted to come and look for me. What? Was it only in my house that one struck? You know, I was active that night because I used to stay awake at night. Though. I was active. I have to off my plasma TV. I have to off my phone because I say, I don't understand this kind of thunder. The way it rattles, fear caught me. I said, I only see this one in the realm of the spirit. This one is too physical. I'm telling you, I have seen a thunder before. It broke three. Three. It scattered a tree. That one is not a normal thunder. I'm telling you. One of my friends was playing game when rain was falling. They were playing game. This kind of their peers they play. Thunder came and struck and everything off. Today you can never repair it. You can never repair the TV. I saw the kind of thing. It came part, that thunder came. And it hit the back tire of our machine. I said, Paul, see. Uh-huh. Before you know it, the thing stood from here like this. It hit us there.
And that's how Paul, he went with his boot off. It's crazy. You know, it's crazy. He rotated. You know that kind of road, that airport road? He was moving. Ooh, oh my God. It was like action movies. You know, it's been long I've not watched all those American movies. I saw one live. For some intrigue. I'm telling you.
Oh my God.
But you don't know where I was. You thought I was in the spirit. No, I was there. Because the thunder met it for all of us. It was the clash of the sons of Boanerges. It was the clash of the sons of thunders. Paul was shouting, "Woyo!" His clothes, yeah! Everything scattered. Where I was. But I refuse to die. No, I didn't know where I was. I thought I was in the belly of a fish. I thought heaven and earth has passed away. I thought, oh my God. What? The spirit held my hand to the ground. And he pressed it to the ground. And he took my leg and put it on the ground like this. And that side begin to rotate it. I was trying to move it. It's not possible. Then, my time, they press on the ground too. That's how they were passing with me through. There was no strength for me to shout. No, it's better if you can cry, it's better to cry. But when somebody beat you and tell you not to cry, that one is worse. My fingers, they remove. I saw bone. I said, wow, the devil wants to prove to me that he's strong. At that time, tongues cannot come out. Do you know that was how we were on the ground of us? There was nothing you could do. People begin to weep. Who are these people? What they didn't understand was that people passed through that road, nothing happened to them. We are sons of thunders. Something came to kill us, but we refused to die. And now imagine it was my head that now went and broke on the ground. Imagine it was not Paul Buttocks. Imagine it was also his head that came. You are not there to lay hands on us. Will you even be having the courage to come and raise the dead, or you come and gather and clap and eat food? If anybody eats in the day of death, that person is wicked. You should fast. You should mourn and fast. I don't go to the house if people have died to eat food. I'm telling you, it's not a good testimony. Is there anything to be happy there? Huh? If you cannot cry, why keep quiet? And mourn. Say, mourn with the dead. You can eat after a while, but don't go and eat. You should go and raise the dead. You have failed and you want to go and eat again. Remain in carnality again. Somebody is even asking for opener. That was how we caught Stephen. Stephen came with the car and came and carried us. They took me to one chemist. They put, doctors. Oh my God. That doctor began to cut my hand again and added some spirit. I found the spirit that has afflicted me, adding spirit again. I don't know which pain to feel. But you know, as I'm talking to you right now, everything, I don't even know whether any of that has ever been. Why? I refuse to die. You have to refuse to die. It doesn't matter what the devil does. And one of the only ways for you to refuse to die is to ensure that you are dying now in the place of prayer. Do you know, as the devil tried to do all of those things to us, what happened? Nothing. The only thing, our body was afflicted small. The Bible says the tail end of the life of Job, God restored what? Almost, how many times? Four times? For Job. For you to understand that everything that the devil did, restoration, In fact, see, from that time, I experienced a shift. A revelation increase, influence increase. Eh? If you want the carnal aspect too, money increase in the account. Devil can never dwindle and succeed over your life. If he destroy your car, cars will come. If he destroy an aircraft, aircraft will come. If he destroy a bike, bikes will come. If he destroy your phone, phones will come. So please, do not refuse to conform to whatever the devil does. So when we say pray, take it very serious. This man, what? Refuse to. The most important point there is what? Refuse to. Never die spiritually. Everybody enter a relationship after that would not see them again. You refuse to die after a relationship. Everybody marry after they marry, they backslide. You what? Refuse to die. When you refuse to die, you will never die. If you agree to die, you will die, even if you don't want to die. Do you know why you sleep and you wake up every day? Because you refuse to die. Some people sleep and they don't wake up. I'm telling you, I realized a long time ago that I, Philip Cephas, will refuse to die. It does not matter what the devil does. Sometimes you are traveling, you know that this thing is supposed to crash. You know that this part is supposed to happen. You just refuse it. If it happens, highest, you will still survive. That's why people enter car. Everybody will die there. They will survive. Why? Because they did not believe they would die. You enter car. You are not believing the car will crash. All of those are daily. They enter a car. And they were moving. She called. Apostle, pray for me. I said, what's the issue? She said, this car that we are moving like this. Say she believe it, not this canoe. Why? That the way it's going as if they will have accident on the road. There are unbelievers in that car. Somebody even stole phone there. In fact, one lady there is more carnal. In fact, there is a guy in the car that just maybe just finished sleeping with a lady. He did not believe that the car will crash. You, that is righteous, spiritual, under authority, you believe that the car will crash. Your expectation will not be cautious. It will be unto you according to the level of your faith. So the car will crash. He said, no, our boss is not like that. I said, oh, what are you doing? Can't you refuse to make the car? You are in the car so that the car will not even crash. Can't you say because of you, nothing will happen? Most time when I'm traveling, when I'm about to enter a plane, when I'm about to enter a car, I will say that I am coming here, nothing will happen in this place. Nothing. And it will be like that. The people there are preserved because of you. That's why you're a righteous person. Bible says, by one man's sin, death come to the world. So also by one man's obedience, righteousness will come to the world. Adam sinned, wahala come. Jesus Christ came in obedience. You are delivered. Can't you believe that by your own obedience, your family is preserved? Yes, your father is supposed to die, but because of you, can't he be preserved? I get what I'm saying now. So please, you must have to what? Refuse to. Let's not hear testimony that you are dead. I don't like it. All of you here, let nobody die before me. Is that okay? Let nobody. You are too young to die. Look at you. You are too young. Too young to die. I'm telling you, it's an evil thing for a believer to die like a chicken. It's an evil thing. We have to refuse. We will be a generation that refuse to die. What will make us survive? We beckon upon the Lord to keep us. Not by our strength, but by the Spirit of the Lord. Don't believe any report that is not of the Lord. Don't. Even if doctors tell you you have 3 days to live, tell the doctor I will come and attend your burial ceremony. The doctor that told my mother she would die, he's dead by now. He's dead. That's it. They scheduled that they should die after operation, whatever. She didn't do the operation. She didn't die. He's the one that was struck later on and he died. There are people that doctors have passed by that your cancer is stage 4 and you will die after so days. Today they have lived beyond that age and the doctors are dead. You can refuse to die and you will not die. People travel from here and go to Sokoto, they die on the road. You will travel, you will not die. But you believe you will die. You will die. Please, you must refuse. Refuse to die. This thing is strange, but you have to. Do you know that John the Beloved was tied in his hand and they dragged him to the island of Patmos? He didn't die. When he was about to die, he said what? I was in the spirit on the last day. You can refuse to die. He did what? Not yet. Said instead of dying, he traveled to the realm of the spirit. So please, instead of dying, please travel to the realm of the spirit for us. Please. Is that okay now? I don't want to hear that after a few years, many of you backslide. Don't do that one. Please, refuse to. No, you know, backsliding is dead. So refuse to die. Many people, fire for God. Now they are dead. And they cannot resurrect again. Please. And you know a challenge? The way you are praying now like this, if you backslide, devil will ensure he keep you on the ground very well. He will put more demons to keep you on the ground. Please, refuse to die. Refuse to. You have to refuse. Is that okay? Please try. Try. Everything that comes to make you backslide, refuse. Force yourself to pray. Force yourself to fast. Force yourself to study. Force yourself to listen to music. Just force yourself. What's the worst that can happen? The worst that can happen is nothing. Because nothing will happen to you. Or you end up leaving. Please. Is that okay? I don't like when we get to see people backslide. It pains me. I was coming and saw some of these our guys. I'm like, look at these people. These are people that used to be on fire for God. People that were praying as if they will bring down the roof of, you know, they will bring down the roof. But today, they are backslidden. They will believe that you will not continue. You have to make him a liar. Because he's a liar, but you have to prove it. Let sin not take you away from God. I don't care if you sin. You see, you know, sometimes we strive for you to be holy and live a holy life. Yes, I understand. But you see, don't be too foolish enough for your sin to take you out of the presence of God. I'm telling you, it's foolishness. Will you, if you go out of the presence of God, will that one solve it? You do not. Remain. Let God deal with you. If God did not kill you when you are doing the sin, don't worry. Repent. Then let's continue. I get what I'm saying now. For many of you, most times, I was in a meeting. I say, pray. One day he said she will not pray. I say, why? Say she's not right with God. I say, look at this rubbish. How many seconds will it take you to be right with God? How many seconds? Just repent and continue. Because the devil is happy that he has kept you the way you are now. So please, when we say engage this thing, pray. When we say pray, do it. Forget that you have sinned. I know I want you to be perfect, it's true. But let me tell you, God's not a human being. No. Every English you are speaking, all the revelation, all this I'm teaching you, all of this, God can come and live with you individually and he'll break all this protocol and he will still work with you. Now I'm telling you the truth. God does not need to appear to us because our doctrines are right. That's why it will amaze you. With all your revelation you know, God will forget you. I'm going to appear to somebody that don't even have any revelation. Okay, so it's not my fortune that revelation. Do you know what I'm saying now? That's why no matter how it is, God appears to people in deeper life. Appears to people in Catholic Church. Appears to people in Cholibam Salafi. Appears to people in Redeem. Why? It doesn't come because our doctrine is right. No. Your heart posture matters so much. So please, try your best. Is that okay now? So as the man that refused to die, take us further. Please refuse to. Whether you like it or not, the time we have a portion for this prayer, we don't finish. But I'm trying to let you understand the need for you to pray. Is that okay now? Yusuf, we have to pray. Is that okay now? You see the reason why many of us go through the things we go through, we didn't die. It's simply because we refuse to die, number one, too. Is that okay? Please try. Because if you don't understand this thing, you fly on the plane will bring you down. It's not about buying private jet. It's about whether the private jet will not bring you down. Because you can buy private jet and you die with the jet. Many people die the day they buy a car. They just say, let them test the car. They were good in, oh, the car crashed with them. They could have entered public transport. Now I'm telling you, sincerely speaking, there are people that got visa to go abroad. As they were going, something happened. So it's not just enough for an open door. No, let the door remain open. Keep it open. If not, some will shut you down inside. So you went to US, from US, we didn't hear of them again, they backslide. I know a guy who was a pastor, he got a scholarship to Kingston, US. And I'm thinking, I don't know what the guy is doing again. He only seen put pictures and videos of what the rubbish that is going around there. Some open doors can be some rubbish in these guys. Many of you are good people, they go to campus, you become bad. Why? Because you choose to die. You must refuse to die. I get what I'm saying now. Refuse to die. Many of you today, you change location. No SBI again. Now you have the time here now. When I was coming, I was wondering, this is the first retreat that faith is not here, right? Faith. I don't know where she is now. Let's be frank. Let's be frank. Is faith praying this now? Is she praying now? Don't deceive yourself. She's not praying any retreat now. Why? There is no SBI. There is no anybody forcing her to come and do 1 12-hour prayer now. The way you are, you will go to school tomorrow, you will marry tomorrow, you will leave this place tomorrow. You may not have anybody to force you like this. Take advantage of this time. Mentors, I hear people too soon leave. If you don't go and be doing the retreat in your house, refusing to die will be very hard for you. Because you don't know when you wake up, I have not prayed for 2 weeks over, boy. Ah, David, speaking this tongue, said, you try to do boom, 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 boom. It's called the tongues has finished. You must refuse to die. No, you must refuse to die. I know a lady that married, after she married, after honeymoon, she came back, she said she wanted to be born again. Why? Because she forgot everything that looked like God. Appetite of God disappeared. When honeymoon speaks some tongues, your husband said, what is this? He said, that's what brought you to me. I prayed you to my life, and I will pray you to keep you. So please, refuse to die. I'm not planning to die spiritually. Don't die. Kwanza is not planning to die spiritually. Neither is my cousin. Refuse to die. Even if we choose to die, let you people rise. So that tomorrow you look at and say, hey, these people are the people that mentor us. Look at them today, they are backslide. I have mentors that are backslide though. There are stories I cannot share because some of them used to listen to my messages. Allah, I have mentors that are past, like plenty of them. People that we used to touch their feet like this so that we can tap anointing. Today they are rubbish. So then try to call me today, I'm too busy for them. Not because I choose to be busy, my number is always in flight mode. I get what I'm saying now. Refuse to backslide. That even if we fail, you don't fail. Rise. So that when we look at you, we know that at least we know how much we do our faith. But if we fail, you too, you fail. Angama. There will not be any difference. Is that okay? So please, please. Let's what? Refuse to die. When we're praying, some people are not praying. Some people are doing as if they are our supervisor here. Please, we don't need wise supervisors. If you don't want to pray, you shouldn't have come for this. This is a boot camp. This is a retreat. Prayerlessness is contagious. If you are not praying, somebody will contact that not praying. If you are praying, others too will follow you and pray. Is that okay now? Please, I just say this to let you understand that. Please, let's try, no matter what, to refuse to die and ensure that we keep on praying. Is that okay? So the man that refused to